हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इट इज़ ए डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम वीक 5 असाइनमेंट ऑफ एनपीटीईएल कोर्स ऑफ जून 2019। नाउ कमिंग टू द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। चूज द करेक्ट सीक्वेंस बाय विच अ ब्राउजर कैन इंटरैक्ट विद द एक्चुअल डेटा स्टोर्ड इन द डिस्क यूजिंग थ्री लेयर वेब आर्किटेक्चर। विल सी व्हाट इज अ थ्री लेयर वेब आर्किटेक्चर। This is a three-layer web architecture, right? In three-layer web architecture, a browser is interacting with the server through network using a protocol called HTTP, we call Hypertext Transfer Protocol. And browser sends a request to the server. Server sends a response to the browser in the form of HTML document, we call Hypertext Markup Language Documents. And whenever a request comes to the server, first it will be come to the web server. From web server it will go to the application server, and through application server it goes to database server, and in the database server will get data from the database which is consisting of disks. And similarly the response will be given to the browser in the opposite way, means again data, database server, application server, web server and so on, and to the browser. Here we should understand what is a web server. Web server is a program running on the server machine which accepts a request from the web browser and sends back results in the form of HTML document. And here application server, or we call application program, it is communicates with the database server using some database connectivity mechanisms like ODBC database connectivity, or we call JDBC database connectivity, means we call open database connectivity, and Java database connectivity, or other protocols, so that we can get or we can store data into the disks. Now what is the order? Web server, application server, database server, and database. This is an order. Now we'll check which orders are correct according to the options given. Here option A is web server, application server, data, then database server. But actually it should be first database server, then data, so that it is not in the order, so that option A is wrong. Now coming to the option B, web server, it is first one, database server, second, web server, database server, application server. So here it is application server, database server is the third one, application server is second one. It is missing the order. Means application server should come first, then database server. Why? Because application server communicates with the database server. So option B is also incorrect. Now coming to question option C, web server, it is the first one, then application server, second one, then database server, third one, finally data, it is fourth one. Now it is a correct representation. So answer for this question is option C. And we'll check for option D also. Application server, it started with 2, then web server, it is 1. First web server, then application server. So that option D is incorrect. So answer for the question is option C. Coming to question number 2, the different uniform resources used to identify and locate web resources in the web are uniform resource identifiers, URI, uniform resource locator, URL, and uniform resource name, URN. Question is, find the incorrect statement. Question is incorrect statement from the following regarding URI, URL, and URN. Now we'll see what is URI consists of. URI can be classified as, here you can see, URI can be classified as URN. URI can be classified as URN and URL are both. And URN resembles that name of the resource. Means resource is identified by its identity, we can call. Our identity means name. Suppose I am identified with my name. URL is for locating the resource. It is called, URL is for locating the resource. See, I am a person, I can have my own identity with name. And what that is, I am calling URN, resource name. What URL specifies my address to locate me is called URL. It is for locating, it is for identity. Now we'll see which statement is incorrect. Option A given, URI can either be an URN or URL or both. So it is correct because URI can be URN or URL, we can say, or we can say both. Based on this diagram, we can say. So this is a correct statement, we call true statement. Question is incorrect statement. So we have to check for incorrect statement. Option B given, URN, uniform resource name. What for resource name? Use it for identifying a web resources. Correct, URN identify web resources. It is true by its name. That's why the name of, that's why the name URN, uniform resource name, given in the namespace. So option B is also true. Now look for option C. What is option C given? URL provides, URL, uniform resource locator, provides the functionality of pointer to locate a web resource. What for URL for locating a web resource in the web? This is also true state. Coming to option D. URL identifies. What for URL for locating? What it is given? URL defines something's identity. Something's identity is represented with URI, not with URL. This is incorrect statement. While URN provides a location, for providing a location, it should not be URN, it should be URL. Okay, it is called locator. So this statement is a false statement. The question is incorrect statement. So we can conclude with option D. Option D is the correct answer for the question number 2. Coming to question number 3. The different storage mediums used, different storage mediums used are cache memory, main memory, flash memory, we can say, magnetic disks, optical disks, and magnetic tapes. These are the different types of storage mediums we have to store data. Now question is, choose the correct ordering we have to find of these mediums according to their access speed. So means according to access speed, means from which medium we can access the data fast, but this order is from slower to faster. We know that cache memory is the fastest one, means if data is there in the cache, retrieving it will take very lesser time compared with other storage mediums. So to answer this question, we need to know the hierarchy of these storage mediums. Here the hierarchy is given. We call primary storage. Primary storages are called cache memory and main memory. These are fastest memories, okay? These are fastest one. And flash and magnetic disk we call somewhat faster, but slower when compared with main memory and cache memory. And optical disk and magnetic tapes are slower memories, means accessing will take more time. And here in the diagram it is clearly mentioned, volume of store, it is top to down. Why? Because cache memory is of lesser space, main memory is somewhat bigger. Like this, when you go for the magnetic tapes, highest storage is possible. But here you see the cost or speed of access, it is in the opposite direction, it is inversely proportional. And accessing from the magnetic tape will take more time when compared with accessing data from the cache memory. Okay, so because my question is based on the access speed from slower to faster. What is slower? You can see slowest we can call magnetic tapes. It's over optical disk, it's over magnetic disk, it's over flash memory, above main memory, and it's above cache memory. So cache memory is the fastest one. So we have to look in this order. Question is for order, then we'll go with an options. What is an option A given? Option A given is magnetic tape. Magnetic tape, which is in the bottom, correct. It's above, we have magnetic disks. Okay, all mediums are not mentioned, only some of them are mentioned. For that only we need to find the order. So after magnetic tapes we have a magnetic disks. Okay, this is disks is correct. And cache memory, after magnetic disk we have a cache memory, it is correct. And after cache memory, main memory is given, but cache should be after main memory, right? Cache should be after main memory, because cache is after main memory. So option A is wrong. Now we go with option B. Magnetic tape, here you observe magnetic tape, then magnetic disks, okay, and main memory, okay, then cache memory, okay. So order is correct only. So option B is correct. Look for option C. Magnetic disk, it is a magnetic disk, then magnetic tape is given. So it is order is given first magnetic disk, then magnetic tape. But actually first magnetic tape, because it's slower in speed, then magnetic disk. So option C is incorrect. Now look for option D. First optical disk, this one, okay, then flash memory, okay, then main memory, okay, then cache memory. This order is a correct sequence. Then we can say option D is also correct answer. So answer for question number 3 is both B and D. Coming to question number 4, consider a table which contains the salary of employees. A table is given that is containing the salary of employees. A new salary 15,200 is inserted into this table, after which the pointers are rearranged as shown in figure. Okay, this is a figure it is shown. Now question is, which of the following file organization is used to represent this? Now what file organization is representing? Just observe it. First 10,000s, then 12,000s, then 12,500, then 13,250. Actually 15,250 is inserted at this point. And here you observe 10,000 is pointing to 12,000s. It's next record in the order. Okay, that you keep in mind. It is stored in the order. Then 12,500 pointing to 12,500, correct. And 12,500 pointing to 13,250. But here you see, when 15,200 is inserted in the table after 25,000s. After inserting, these pointers are adjusted. Now 15,200 should appear between 13,250 and 17,000. So that the pointer is of 13,250 should point into this 15,200. This is a fifth record. Then sixth record should be 17,000. So that this fifth record should point to this sixth record in the order. Then next is 25,000. This sixth record should point at seventh record. So according to this, what we understand is the database records are in the ordered fashion. Ordered fashion means it is using sequential file organization. That is option A. And there are other options are given. Heap file organization. Heap file stores records anywhere in the file where there is a place. But is it storing in unordered fashion? No. It is storing in the ordered fashion based on the pointers. Based on the pointers, this file organization we call sequential file. So option B wrong. And option C given multi-table clustering file organization. Store records of several different relations in the same file. But it is about one relation. So that option C is incorrect. And option D given hash file organization. Actually hash file organization uses hash function like we call h of k. That hash function will decide that record to placed into which block of the file. But it is not according to the hash file organization. And moreover, hash file organization is called unordered file organization. But based on these pointers, we can call it is ordered file organization. So that option D is also incorrect. So we can go with an option A. A is the correct answer for question number 4. Coming to question number 5. What is question number 5? Which of the following is not true about? Not true. Keep in mind. Which of the following is not true about business logic layer used in modal view controller architecture? We call MVC architecture. In MVC architecture, the business logic and presentation layer are separated. And it had a benefit that because you separate business logic with presentation, when you do modifications to the presentation, it is not disturbing the business logic. Similarly, when you do any modification in the business logic, it is not affecting the presentation. That is the reason that business logic and presentation are separated in modal view controller architecture. Now here the question is, these options are given and we need to find which is not true. Here in model view architecture, model specifies a business logic view for presentation layer. We also call business layer and presentation layer. Business layer is representing model and presentation layer representing presentation of data and depends on display devices. We call view. And controller for events and executing the actions, we use controller. In this, what it is asking, about business logic layer. Actually, business logic layer provides high level view of data and actions on the data. Look for option A. It deals with users interaction. Users interaction is dealt by presentation layer, not the business logic layer. Okay, it is not the business logic layer. So that option A is incorrect because question is about business logic layer, not with the presentation layer. So business logic not deals with user interaction. Option A, wrong. Now look for option B. Option B, it enforces business rules for carrying out actions. It is a true statement. It is a false statement. Now option C, it hides details of data storage schema. Yes, it is going to hide the details of data storage schema. It is hiding details of data storage schema. It is also true statement. And option D given, it does not provide highest level view of data and actions on data. What it is given, it does not provide. It does not provide. But actually, here you look, it provides high level view of data and actions on data. Because it is mentioned, it does not provide, this statement is false. Now coming to the question, what is the question? Which of the following is not true? Not true. Which is not true means false. That is an option A and option B are false statement. So answer for this question is both option A and option D. So answers for the question number 5. Coming to question number 6. Identify which of the following is not a disk arm scheduling algorithm. Disk arm scheduling algorithms. We have 5 disk arm scheduling algorithms. We call first come first serve, FCFS, and we have elevator, we call scan algorithm, and we also have C scan algorithm. We have C look algorithm, and also we have shortest seek time first, SSTF algorithm. These are the 5 algorithms we have here. A small presentation saying first come first serve, FCFS, shortest seek time first, SSTF, elevator or scan algorithm, or circular scan, we call C scan, C look, circular look. We have these 5 algorithms are there. Now check with on options. First come first serve, it is a scheduling algorithm there, it is true. Shortest remaining time first, this is not there. Elevator or scan scheduling there, circular scan or C scan scheduling is there. Now question is not a disk arm scheduling algorithm, which is not a disk arm scheduling algorithm, B. So B is not a disk arm scheduling algorithm. Question number 7. Consider relation employee, EID, ename, salary, designation, city, email. Using schema refinement, we obtained these 2 functional dependencies. I can call this is FD1, this is FD2. 2 functional dependencies. Question is, find out the number of key attributes, in the above relation. What is a key? It is a set of attributes. It is a set of attributes that uniquely identifies, each tuple in a relation. And key we can find based on the functional dependencies. Now look for the functional dependency 1. If I find the closure of EID, employee ID, I'm going to get employee ID, employee name from FD1, salary, designation, and city. This is specifying all the attributes of employee table. Any attribute closure determining all the attributes of a relation, then it is called key of the relation. We call EID is a key. We check with FD2. In FD2, left hand side is email. When I find the closure of email, I'm going to get attributes email and EID. With EID, here you can see, with based on FD1, we can able to get ename, salary, designation, city. Again, these are all the attributes. Because these are all attributes, then we can call email is also key. What are the key attributes? Now we have two keys. One is EID and another is email. Means there are two key attributes. So question is, find out the number of key attributes. How many key attributes? EID, email are two key attributes. So that we can go with an option C. C is the correct answer for the question number 7. Question number 8. Which of the following RAID level is called block interleaved distributed parity? Here the question is about RAID, R-A-I-D. This RAID specifies redundant array of independent disks. Abbreviation of RAID is redundant array of independent disks. It is also called redundant array of this I, we call inexpensive disks. With RAID, several hard disks are made into one logical disk. Means there are many disks, disk 1, disk 2, disk 3, disk 4, disk 5. Likewise, many disks are connected in some particular way to make the large storage. That's why we can call it is redundant array of disks. That's why we call it is redundant array of disks. This is for providing large storage. And RAID having several levels. We have RAID 0 and RAID 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now we also have 6. 6 we have. And in that, RAID 0 is called stripping. RAID 0 is for stripping. And RAID 1 is for mirroring. We call it is mirroring. And here RAID 2 we call RAID 2, here it added some information in the slide. RAID 2 is called memory style error correcting codes. RAID 3, level 3 is called bitter interleaved parity. And level 4 we call block interleaved parity. Level 5 we call block interleaved distributed parity. And RAID level 6 we call it is a dual parity. Okay, it is a dual parity. This information may be useful for your some more questions in your exams. Okay, these are the 6 RAID levels. Now coming to the question. Question is, which of the following RAID level is called block interleaved distributed parity? Block interleaved distributed parity is therefore RAID level 5. So answer for the question is option D, and the remaining options are incorrect options. Option B, option A are incorrect option. So the correct answer for the question number 8 is option D. Question number 9. Choose the incorrect statement from the following. Options are given. Option A, data dictionary stores the information about schema definition. This is a true statement. Why? Because data dictionary stores information about the schema. Like what are the attributes? What are the domain names? What are the constraints? That all are stored into the data dictionary. It is a correct statement. Option B says data dictionary stores information about integrity constraints. Suppose table have some conditions like check constraints, primary key constraints. That information also will be stored into the data dictionary. Option C given, data dictionary does not store user accounting information of database. User accounting information, simply say it is like passwords. Passwords or authorizations, such information. But actually data dictionary stores, here instead of saying does not stores, and say does store, then it is true. But it is given does not store, then we can call it is a false statement. And option D given, data dictionary stores the information about file organization. That is also true, means what file organization, ordered or heap file organization it is used. That information also maintained in the data dictionary. This is a true statement. Because question is incorrect statement, answer is option C, because C is the incorrect statement. Question number 10. Which of the following is true about HTTP? What is HTTP? HTTP is called Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is a connectionless protocol. Actually, HTTP is always used in application layer. And transport layer, network layer, presentation layers are incorrect. And you can go with an option A. Because it is a connectionless, because all option A, B, C, D given connectionless only. Anyhow, all are connectionless. We don't have any problem with connectionless. But HTTP is used in application layer, not in the transport network and presentation layer. So we can go with on option A. A is the correct answer for the question.